today, I will talk about our association with others. Association with others will help us break limits. Because this month we are saying it's a month of breaking the limits. And I know that God will help us as we get into the Bible and see how association with others helped some people to break limits. And today, it will be a lesson to us. And this will be a lesson to us when we know these things from the Bible. And then we'll be able to break the limits in our days. I want to say that people are a great resource. The person sitting next to you is a great resource. And when you have the right kind of people around you, you will be able to break the limits. Men will encourage you when you are discouraged. And an example that we shall look and we are looking at is the example of Paul and Barnabas. And as we know that Paul had a great potential in him, and this man, being a Pharisee, that is a teacher of the law, and a man of great zeal, he was dedicated to the cause when he was a Pharisee. So he was so serious about what he was to do. After his conversion, at some point he got disappointed and discouraged. And so he had to go away for some time. Because the people around, the people that were around him did not believe, did not accept that this guy has changed. And so he had to go into a different direction. Because the church in Jerusalem and all the like, they did not believe that surely this guy has changed. And so he was so much down. And we'll see this in the book of Acts chapter 11 from verses 25 and verses 26. And when you read this portion of scripture, we see that with this kind of a life that Paul was leading, he needed somebody to encourage him. And so there is this guy called Barnabas, as we are going to read. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul. You remember that Paul is called he's called Saul of Tarsus. So this guy called Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul. And when he found him, he brought him to Antioch. So for a whole year, Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught great number of people. The disciples were called Christian first at Antioch. Amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana.
Amen.
So this this young man called Barnabas.
Kwa hivyo huyu kijana alikuwa anaitwa Barnabas.
Another name is the son of encouragement.
Alikuwa anaitwa mwana wa kutia nguvu.
He had to go to look for Saul.
Lazima angemtafuta Sauli.
This is after the conversion of Paul in Acts chapter 9.
Hii ni baada ya kubadilishwa kwake Sauli.
When he got converted.
Wakati alibadilishwa.
What I told you that he somehow got disappointed and discouraged and he went back to Tarsus. And this young man decided, and he was actually sent by the church in Jerusalem to go and look for this man called Saul. And so when he went there, he found Saul.
Akampata Sauli,
whose name was changed to Paul.
Baadaye jina lake lilikuwa limebadilishwa likawa Paulo.
And he took time and he took him to and he brought him to Antioch.
In other words,
he took Paul.
Akamchukua Paulo.
He encouraged him.
Akamtia nguvu.
He told Paul.
Akamwambia Paulo.
Me, I know that you are saved.
Mimi najua kwamba wewe umeokoka.
Forget about anybody else.
Sahau kila mtu mmoja.
Don't mind about anybody else.
Usishughulike na mtu yeyote.
Please come with me.
Come
along with me.
Kuja tuende na
wewe. And we go to Antioch.
Na tuende pale Antioch.
And they went to Antioch. So Barnabas told Paul or Saul,
akamwambia Sauli,
now that I have come,
sasa kwa sababu nimekuja,
I want to be part of you.
Nataka kuwa sehemu yako.
And I want to be a member of your team.
Nataka kuwa mshirika katika timu yako.
So he encouraged him.
Akamtia nguvu.
And he told him,
na akamwambia,
let's go to Antioch.
Wacha tuende pale.
So they went to Antioch.
Wakaenda pale Antioch.
And in Antioch they stayed for a whole year.
Na pale Antioch wakakaa.
And they were teaching the brothers and the sisters there.
Walikuwa wanafundisha wadugu na wadada pale.
And when they were teaching,
na wakati walikuwa wanafundisha,
many people believed.
Watu wengi wakaamini.
Many people loved Jesus.
Watu wengi wakampenda Yesu.
And at this time they were teaching and were doing all these things.
Na wakati walikuwa wanafundisha wakifanya haya mambo yote.
There was this other guy who was called John Mark.
Kuna huyu mtu mwingine alikuwa anaitwa John.
He was in Antioch also.
Pia yeye alikuwa pale Antioch.
And they were there.
Na walikuwa.
So they were a team.
Kwa hivyo ilikuwa timu kubwa.
What am I saying?
Je, nasema nini?
Association with others.
Uhusiano kwa moja na mwingine.
So when they were there,
wakati walikuwa pale,
Paul was encouraged. Saul was encouraged.
Sauli ama Paul alikuwa,
and when he was encouraged,
na wakati alikuwa amejazwa
Barnabas,
kwa sababu ya Barnabas,
this is the time,
ndio wakati
he was now to embark with his first missionary journey.
Hiyo ndio wakati alikuwa anataka kuanza missionary yake, safari yake ya kwanza ya missionary.
And they went for the first missionary journey with John Mark and Barnabas.
Na wakaenda katika safari yake ya kwanza wakiwa na John Mark na Barnabas.
I said,
nilisema,
people are great resource.
Nilisema kwamba watu ni rasilimali kubwa sana.
How I pray,
jinsi naomba,
that God will send Barnabas into your life.
Ya kwamba Mungu atatuma Barnabas katika maisha yako.
Hallelujah. That God may send Barnabas into your life.
Ya kwamba Mungu atume Barnabas katika maisha yako.
So that where you have stalled,
kwa sababu ndio mahali,
where you have remained in the same position,
mahali ambapo umekwama,
in whether it is in business,
kama hata ni kama kwa biashara,
somebody will come,
mtu atakuja,
and encourage you,
na kutie nguvu,
and tell you, brother,
na kuambia ndugu,
my sister,
dada yangu,
you will make it,
utaweza.
So my prayer this morning is that God will send Barnabas to your life.
Kwa hivyo ombi langu asubuhi ya leo ni kwamba Mungu akatume Barnabas katika maisha yako.
And when Barnabas are sent into our lives,
na wakati Barnabas wametumwa katika maisha yetu,
things will never be the same again.
Mambo yetu itakuwa imebaki vile tena.
And people around you will cause you to do things that you could not do alone.
Watu ambao wamekuzigula watakusababisha ufanye mambo ambayo ungeweza kufanya ukipe yako.
Probably Paul would have begun to reach to the nations of the Gentiles area.
Pengine Paul angeanza kufikia majenta ama watu wa mataifa kitambo.